What a third sector that was from Pekka Bagnaia, showing once again why he's been the dominant force in the last 2 years here in Mugello. Over the line he goes, and it's a 144.572. So close, not quite good enough for pole. Heading hands there with the white shirt is Ducati boss, the top boss, Claudio Domenicali. He was on site in Barcelona last weekend to see this man produce another brilliant recovery. Now then, it's gone wrong there for Bagnaia. That was coming out of Materazzi and Borgo San Lorenzo.
I guess he lost the rear or the front lifted off. Are we going to see a replay? No, that's already happened there.
Yeah, that's the moment that already happened. This is it, yeah.
I guess it's back on the gas, or is it between the turn that he has a hit between? Yeah. So he's got on the throttle a little bit wide, front's picked off the ground. When it hits the ground, it gets unstable.
So as it stands right now, Bagnaia second for the sprint, but he would drop down to fifth on the grid for the Grand Prix here tomorrow. Looking back with 4 minutes of this Q2 session remaining, already a record-breaking Q2 session. How many times have we said that already so far in 2024? There's the rider fastest in Q1, Frankie Morbidelli, they just sweeping out of your picture. Mark Marquez over line, picking up some slipstream here behind Oliveira on the track out of Aprilia.
Oh, he needed to get, he has got past, but can he? No, he can't. Oh, he did, he stopped it. So now he's kept the lap together, get the advantage of the slipstream down the straight and still stop it and get by. Now he can put the rest of the lap together.
Look at that stat there from Brembo in the Brembo Grand Prix of Italy. Shrubbing off nearly 280 kilometres an hour in just over 7 seconds. Just gives you an idea of the skill and bravery you need when you grab that front brake lever down the hill into San Donato, the first corner.
And you know what Mark's thinking here? If he can catch Frankie Morbidelli at the right moment and get a slipstream down the front straight as well, that'll double slipstream in one lap, that's enough to do the job properly.
This could be getting worse here for Bagnaia, because look at these lap times coming in from the likes of the rider on board with now, and Andrea Bastianini up and on course for pole. Mark Marquez and Jorge Martin both up as well. Oh, somebody's gone down. And is that Mark Marquez?
I think it is.
Yeah, Mark Marquez has been the Grazini Ducati. Is that down the hill into Scarperia? Just has a little check there of his right hand, his right wrist. That's going to bring out the yellow flags in Sector 3. Bastianini was already through. We know that the beast was ahead of Mark Marquez. And now Bastianini will fling the factory Ducati onto its left-hand side. And now he's picking up the drive grip, needing all of that 300 horsepower on the factory Ducati now then, as he comes over the line. Bastianini, no improvement, stays in fifth place. Jorge Martin then, we're riding on board now with the Martinator already. 144.504 has him on course for pole position. No improvement as well from Martin. So Marc Marquez down at the, in Sector 3. So at best, Marquez will find himself fourth on the grid. Aleix Espargaró is running off into San Donato. He was on such a hot lap there, Marquez. He was over a quarter of a second clear
on
this lap.
Into the right, not always front here. Yeah.
That was a potential pole lap for Marc Marquez. He was absolutely flying through the first two sectors. Look at the front, tucking from underneath him. Down he goes in a cloud of dust into the gravel trap then at the Scarperia corner. So at best, he will be in fourth place. Maverick Vinales on a really good lap. The Top Gun was up by a tenth of a second through the first half of this current lap. No reference at all here for Vinales, so he's doing all the work on his lonesome. Through now into the Correntino corner, second gear, around 100 kilometres now on the factory Aprilia. Got to pick up the drive grip here, make sure you can attack on the optimum line going through Biondetti 1 and 2. Vinales is still up. If he had a slipstream here down the start finish straight, you'd feel that this was a pole lap. Still could be. Just needs the poke. Doesn't need the grunt, doesn't he, on that factory Aprilia. He's got to nail this last corner to absolute perfection. There's a little bit of a twix there as he got on the gas. 30 seconds, a little bit more remaining in this session. Maverick Vinales, is he on course for pole position here in Mugello? No, stays there on the front row.
The Aprilia is so good through the corners. Probably, arguably, the best machine through the fast corners. Turning but it isn't as fast as the opposition down the straight, especially the Ducati KTM.
It would be a fourth front row in seven this season for Maverick Vinales. Alex Rins, his session is over. At best, he'll be ninth place on the grid. Is there going to be any late change here at the top of the leaderboard? It looks like it's going to be pole position in the Italian Grand Prix, pole position in Pecco Bagnaia's backyard for world championship leader Jorge Martin. Track limits has seen a lap cancel for Pedro Acosta. He's going to find himself off those first two rows now. So it's Martin, Bagnaia and Vinales on the front row as it stands right now. Although Bastianini trying to deliver some late fireworks here in Ducati's home Grand Prix. Follow the beast through Arrabbiata 2. Now he's going to come over that blind crest, drop down the hill. This is where Marc Marquez crashed out when he was flying. Up by over a quarter of a second was Marquez when he flung it into the gravel trap there at Scarperia. Halfway through this third sector, there now goes Bastianini. As it stands at the moment, he's on course for P5, middle of that second row of the grid. He's going to come through sector three now. Let's just check his progress. Is it going to be troubling that front row? No, it's not. No, it will not. So it's congratulations to Jorge Martin, it looks like. Quick glance at the timing screens. Martin has got this one nailed with another all-time lap record. We saw one in Q1 from Morbidelli. Yeah, they know it's all over. The 144.504 secures Jorge Martin his 16th pole position of his MotoGP career, 37th in total.
We came into this session wondering what was happening with Jorge. He didn't look comfy in the session before, and he just stomps on any doubts.
Yeah,
brilliant.
Found something special, didn't he? Just when he needed it the most. Alex Marquez looking to improve on 11th place on the grid, and he does, up to 8th. That spells bad news for Yamaha, because that's pushed Alex Rins onto row 4 in 10th spot. And once again, another clear message in Ducati's home Grand Prix, in Ducati's backyard. A clear message from Jorge Martin. How dare you overlook me for that factory Ducati seat alongside Bagnaia in 2025. Look what it means to the world championship leader. Doesn't matter what happens over the next 24 hours or so here in Mugello, he will lead the world championship going to the iconic Dutch TT in Assen towards the back end of June.